This will be setup of the Ecobee smart camera. First, you're going to open up your Ecobee app and you're going to come to the plus sign in the upper left-hand corner and then select add a device. In this case, we're going to add a camera. And before we get started, have your Wi-Fi network password readily available. Ensure your smart camera is within range of the Wi-Fi router and then plug in your smart camera to an outlet. We're going to select okay, got it. So it's telling us to remove the film, which we already did. Ensure your camera is plugged in and the lights are glowing amber, which they are currently right now. So we're going to say good to go. Searching for devices, it found it and it's displaying the serial number. I'm going to tap on that to get going. Now it wants us to select the network. So I'm going to put this on my IoT network very quickly. And it does actually make you confirm the password twice. So that's different from other devices that I've set up. But here we go. It is the serial number of the device saying that it temporarily wants to connect to the cell phone. So it's verifying.
Successfully connected to Wi-Fi network.
Said successfully connected. Probably heard that. And it's still verifying. Verification process does take a little time. Keep an eye on your status lights. Can take upwards of 5 minutes to do. So we're just gonna let that sit back and do what it needs to do. All right, so we've got options now for securing the account. Can either be via SMS or an authenticator. Now it will not let me skip this step. So I'm going to select use the authenticator. Oh, it wants me to put the password in. All right, we're gonna use the less secure SMS. And it wants my Ecobee password, so we're gonna take care of that for a second. So if you manage to back out of the setup of the 2FA, you cannot actually access the camera feed until you set up 2FA. So you will need to put in your password in order to set that up. So in my case, I'm going to link an authentication app. And once I do that, it's gonna ask me for the code, after which it asks us to sign into our Ecobee account, which you then have to enter your one-time code again. So it might actually be better, not as secure, but to use SMS, because then you don't have to go back and forth between your app, or if you have it on another phone, it might be helpful and you can do it that way. After all that rigmarole, we have now been able to access our account. So it's giving us a little thing up here to complete my home. It's recommending some sensors. I also get 60 days left in a trial so I can complete setup. Welcome to Ecobee Smart Security. Get started. So arm away, but disarm. Next, view incidents, disarm, next. There's an incident, sends it to your phone. We go okay. I can enable the smoke alarm alert, which means it will listen for a smoke alarm and send me a notification. So I'm gonna say, yep, go ahead. All right, so get peace of mind, rapid SOS professional monitoring. So that I don't know about. Maybe we'll set that portion up later. Maybe we get 60 days of that. Turning on the camera. Gonna have to do that by default. Kind of go up in there into the settings, and there is actually my camera right there. Live view right there. All right, that was the setup for the Ecobee smart camera.